And thanks to KFC for delivering some new Kentucky Fried Wings for the crowd here. Barbecue, honey barbecue, Nashville hot sauce. They got it all here in Denver. And look, it's only week 7, but try telling Eagles and Cowboys fans not to panic. After what went down last week, the pressure's on in Dallas Sunday night.
We get set for the Vikings and the Eagles.
Put them out of their misery.
Steps up, floats a bomb up the right seam, looking for Anderson. He's got it! They're not going to catch him.
The kick is away, and the kick is good, and the Jets lead by 8. Prescott up the middle, bangs over the goal line. Touchdown, Cowboys. A 2-point conversion away from coming all the way back. Prescott back in the gun, throws it in the end zone, incomplete. So the Cowboys are going to come up short by 2 points.
A couple weeks ago, Dallas was looking like maybe the best team in the NFC. Now, 3 straight losses, and they're tied with Philly at 3-3. And despite everything, Doug Peterson's confident, like Joe Namath confident.
I know the sky's falling outside.
Yes.
You know, it's falling, and I get that, and the fans are reeling just a little bit. But you know, we're going down to Dallas, and our guys are going to be ready to play, and we're going to win that football game. And when we do, we're in first place in the NFC East. We control our own destiny. We're right where we need to be. Has it been perfect or beautiful or all of that? No. But all we got to do is try to be 1-0 this week, beat the Dallas Cowboys. We're in first place.
Very confident there. Time for a play with abandon presented by Wrangler. So look, Joe, I'm not saying that this is a must-win game. I'm definitely not saying that. Maybe I am saying that. But will the loser on Sunday still make the playoffs?
Let me tell you, Colleen, the loser of this game is getting left in the laundromat. Because in the NFC East, there's only one team that's going to make the playoffs, and it's the team that wins the division. Intra-division games are so important. The Eagles, the Cowboys, those are the two teams that are going to be battling for the division crown. And whoever wins this game's got that inside track and won't relinquish that the rest of the season.
Yeah, I mean, like, left in the laundromat, that is a great way to put
that
it,
is
Joe.
It's really tough when you're in the laundromat and you're watching everybody else go to the playoffs. Bad place to be.
Yeah.
I grew up in a laundromat, so I can tell you this. This is a must-win game for both teams. When you look at the Dallas Cowboys, they lack depth. They have some injuries. And also their bread and butter is no longer their bread and butter. They're not running the ball efficiently. They're relying on Dak Prescott to win the game for them. Their number one wide receiver, Amari Cooper, is down. And now they're expecting Michael Gallup to pull a rabbit out of his tush and do some amazing things. It's not going to happen. He's a young player, but he's not ready to be the number one guy.
And I'm concerned about the Cowboys in this matchup also now, just because they're hurting in key places on their football team. I do believe, though, Philly will still have a chance if they lose. But if the Cowboys lose this game, it would be tough for them to get back into the playoff hunt. Let's think about this. They have the toughest remaining schedule, I think, in the National Football League. Yeah, they're at the Giants, but then they got the Vikings, the Lions, the Pats, the Bills, the Bears, the Rams. And before they go back to the Eagles on December 22nd. This is, and I know we're in week 7, a must-win for the Dallas Cowboys. And they have to find a way to win this football game because Amari Cooper may be out. And it's up to Michael Gallup to stand up and stand out and man up and make plays. Michael Gallup had made huge strides in his development this year, and I expect great things out of him. Now, last couple weeks, things haven't been going so well. This Jets game was a tough game for him. This week, you see what Philly gave up to Stephon Diggs. He has to step up and be the leader and be the number one guy if Amari Cooper is not playing.
Well, he has a chance because 32 for the Philadelphia Eagles. And now I'm not going to say his name. I'm just going to say his number because he was out there getting taken to the woodshed.
The Eagles aren't even playing tonight. We don't have to go pick out people.
But on the other side of Steve.
Where they're hurting at both tackles.
Yes.
Now you watch Stephon Diggs go up top. Michael Gallup may not have time to go up top because of that.
I think Michael hit on really the most important injury theme. Dallas has had a lot of injuries this season, but their real injury theme is the tackles are injured. They're not able to efficiently run the football like they have been, and it's hurting play action, which is where Dak thrives the most. And
he's one of the best.
Right. He is one of the best at play action, but without that running game rolling the way it had been, he's just not the same quarterback, and that team and that offense is just not the same, and it's caused a couple losses.
And you couple that with the fact that the Eagles have the second-ranked run defense out there. That could be tough with the injuries and that. So let's, for fun here, why don't we pick the game? All right? Yeah, this sounds like a great exercise. Okay, so, Steve, you're first.
I begrudgingly picked the Eagles.
Okay. You don't like the Eagles?
Nah, I mean, I got to pick the – I already said
gotta pick somebody, I guess.
Weak-ass game, so I pick one of them.
Wow, all right.
I like the Eagles. You know what I like is their offense. They're a multiple offense. They can run the football. We saw them a couple weeks ago against Green Bay and Lambeau. They ran all up and down the field on the Packers' defense. But if they need to stand back there in the shotgun and throw the football with Carson Wentz, that's exactly what they can do. So they can beat you in a lot of different ways on offense, and to have that flexibility is really important.
Where are you guys going?
Surely this won't be a sweep, right?
So no one can hear when I pick the Eagles to win that game. Microphone to me. I just think they're hurting in the worst places.
It's all the key positions. It's crushing.
And I would love to see people man up and the Cowboys say, we're not in my house. But it's just hard to see it.
Sunday night football in Dallas. Michael Irvin here on the show. Picking the Eagles
that is so
over
beautiful.
The Cowboys.
This is a beautiful moment.
I feel
moment.
Like this is some type of like reverse jinx voodoo that you have working here, Irv. That better not be it. Hey, you
I
need to talk in the microphone.
Reverse jinx voodoo. I hope it works that way, but I'm just concerned with what we're hurting.
Well, a lot of concerns with both of these teams heading into the week, but we got the Broncos and the Chiefs tonight, and Von Miller, we'll see if he can get going tonight here at Mile High.
Here I go!
Coming up on NFL Game Day Kickoff. This season, it's Lombardi or bust for the defending AFC West champs. But will defense derail Kansas City's dream of a trip to Super Bowl 54?
I'll keep trusting those guys to keep doing their job.
Meanwhile, these Hall of Fame legends line up with two of tonight's toughest defenders.
See more, get more.
That's right.
A pair of can't-miss Thursday night conversations.
You are putting together a body of work that puts you in a class all by yourself.
As NFL Game Day Kickoff, presented by KFC, rolls on. Here I come.